Hey guys, how you doing? Today is Monday, October 13th. How have you been? We've had an interesting couple days around here. We had a tropical storm blow in, but it kind of turned into a hurricane when it hit us. So our yard is a bit of a disaster area. I did some video. My camera, of course, wasn't charged. I managed to take a little bit of video the morning that it was hitting us and what I was observing and trying to videotape it without freaking out the kids. Carrie was scared. This hit us Saturday night. And it was just supposed to be a tropical storm. So then I got up at four and it was windy. And then I got up at five and it was really crazy windy. And six, Kerrigan came flying in her room because she heard, a crash. That would have either been the barbecue taken off or the trees in the yard falling down. So I got up and I put on the hall light, and as I was walking in the hall, the lights flickered, and then we lost power at six. And then you'll see in my video what was going on.
So we're having a tropical storm. I don't have much battery left, but we've lost some trees. That's our barbecue laying there. So it's kind of crazy right now. This is just a tropical storm. Doors are leaking. We lost power about an hour ago. And that's the big tree that's next to us. So that's down. So I'm losing battery, and of course we're out of power. But this is the side of the house, and we put all our patio chairs here, so I think they're pretty crushed right now because the tree kind of landed a little bit on them. A little crazy here right now. This is Tropical Storm Fay, and today is Sunday, October 12th. And the track down here is full of water. So nothing back here is getting wet, so that's okay. Oh yeah, it is. Yep, it's getting wet. So good. So the wind's died down a little bit. Our cable thing, our antenna is still up. Not that we have power. And because we're on a well, we can't flush the toilets. Scott's just heading to work on his scooter. I think he'd be safer in the car, but the scooter he can at least get around fallen trees because he's got to get to the hotel. He's got a full house over there. So Peach is down in the bushes. I checked on her last night, but her tree is now broke. Her tree's gone. That happened just a little while ago. So yeah, it's just, you know, nice quiet Sunday here. At least we can sort of see the ocean now. There he goes. Alright. My craft room was starting to leak. Oh, excuse me. So there's our barbecue. There's Peach's tree. It's broke. The guy next door has that boat in his yard, and that tree's against it now. This tree here is like totally stripped away. And we've got a lot of branches and stuff in the yard, but our scooters are still standing, so that's good. Unfortunately, the car didn't blow away. It's kind of open for that one. So yeah, there's going to be a bit of a mess, and I've got towels. I moved my cabinet over here out of the way.
So that's what was happening around here, and then the kids and I took a drive yesterday to, where were we going? Oh, we went over to the hotel to shower because without power, our well doesn't work, and then we have no water. So we went over to the hotel and snuck down to the pool area, and there's a washroom there. So we went in, and there's a changing room. So we used the showers, and we got clean, and we went to the bathroom. And then we left there, and we took a drive to see what some of the damage was. And I must admit, they did a lot of cleanup in a short period of time, and they've used the guys and girls from the regiment to do some street cleaning and stuff and cutting of trees, and there's a lot of trees and stuff down. So, yeah. So I'm going to show you the footage of our yard once the storm was over. I ended up going out with my scooter helmet on because it was still really blowing and crazy, and I went to check on Peach, and it's actually been a good thing that she's been a little nuts and hiding over the fence, because she's been down in under the grass, and a tree fell on her, a tree branch from her tree, which is now gone, her tree's gone, but she was so far under all the grass and vines and everything that the trunk or the branch landed on, and it was like a big branch, but it landed on her. And she was down underneath, so I'm like yelling to her, and I could hear her squawking. So then I lifted Kerrigan over the fence to see if she could get her, and Peach was all freaked out, so she bit Kerrigan. So we knew she was alive, but she was freaked out completely. Then I sent Kerrigan through the living room window to get my rake, because I couldn't get on the side of the house at all, because there was so many trees and craziness out there. So I sent her through the window to get my rake, which was just outside the window. And then I pulled her and the rake back through the window. And I went outside and I was like raking for 2 minutes, and it was like, what is the point? Like, seriously, when you see the yard, you'll see why. Insert.
Okay. So now that we had our power back, I could charge my video camera. Unfortunately, I didn't have my camera, charged before the storm. So here lives our barbecue now. My landlord helped me put it back together because it was in pieces. And here's our yard at this point. I drug all these branches over here. These were all broken down. And my landlord came up yesterday and had a chainsaw. There's Peach's tree. Peach actually had... You'll see, I don't know if they were, it was some of these logs here were on top of Peach. Now, thank God lately she's been a little bit nuts, and she's been over on the other side of this fence. Where is she? There she is. She's down hi Peachy. Hiya Peach. She's down there. I don't know if you can see. Her head's like down there somewhere. So she's back down under those branches and or under all the grass and stuff. And because she was... There's part of the tree. This was all on top of her. We moved that out of the way. Here's some more pieces that... So my landlord, God love him, he crawled over the fence with his chainsaw and rescued Peach, because Peach was... Her tail's a little feathery looking. But yeah, the branch... Or the... Because she had so much of the grass on top of her, it cushioned her against that tree that fell down, because it was... part of this tree. This one's still dangerously hanging there, so I don't really want to be under that. But yesterday when I realized she was still out here and I hadn't seen her, I came out in the rain. I had my scooter helmet on because I was worried that branches were going to fall on my head. So that's what's left of Peach's tree. This is the other part of the... Notice the chicken coop still stands. We built that sucker pretty tough. It didn't even break at all. But this tree is completely broke up top there. So my landlord and I drug all these branches over here to the, towards the fence. This tree is called a frangipani. Now it's still partly in the ground, and you can pretty much like just clip off that, stick it in the ground, and the thing will start to grow apparently. There's a little lizard. You survived! You did so good! And my leg, I went to put that chair down the other day and I banged it on my leg when I put it down, so I got a wee bit of a bruise. This tree hung in there. He's a little wilty right now. This is a casuarina tree. I hate this tree. I've always hated this tree, although now I feel bad for it. The thing with this tree is that it has pine needles. Let's see if I can find any. It has pine needles that are really long, and it has these little pine cone things, and these are the equivalent of stepping on a Lego. Okay, so if you ever know that pain, it's the same as these little things. They're spiky little pine cones, and they're everywhere, and they come from that tree. And because this tree is on the side of our house, you could never really walk on this side of the house in your bare feet. Now, because of the wind and the craziness and the fact the tree landed in the front yard, we have those little things all over the front yard, all over the backyard. They're everywhere. So, yeah, here's our fence. And you can pretty much get to the other yard now underneath the fence. So there's that part of the tree. And it's on here, and it totally crushed our fence through there. So we can now get around the side of the house. And you'll see that the leaves kind of like splatter into little pieces against the house. I had Kerrigan crawl out that window yesterday because I had my rake right there, and we couldn't get by here at all yesterday until our landlord came up with the chainsaw. So our patio furniture survived. It needs to be washed down. But yeah, I came out with the rake, and here's my rake here, and you can see I kind of didn't really get much done. I made two little piles, and it was, at that point, it was kind of like rearranging deck chairs on the Titanic. It was just, it wasn't really happening. So these are the branches that we've drug over from this tree. It just landed a little bit on the roof, but not like just a few branches. So that all has to be taken away, so we're going to have to cut it down. I've got some leaves up on the roof there that are plugging the drain, because as you know, any rainwater we get is our drinking water, so, and our bathing water, and it's our water. So yeah, so here's the pine needles, and there's those little things before they become little deadly weapons on the ground. So this is today. Today is Monday, October 13th. And guess what? We're getting hit with another storm Thursday or Friday. And it looks like it could turn into a Cat 2 hurricane. So, and Scott was like, he's been at work since like the wee hours of yesterday morning. So he was like, yeah, if you can maybe tidy up the yard a little bit, because things are going to be now projectiles, anything that's laying down. It's like, what would you like me to do, dear? Like, I lifted and drug 10-foot branches around the yard yesterday, so there's nothing really else I can do. So yeah, a lot of raking needs to be done. Our lawn guys will come and they'll cart all this away, but it's gonna be a heck of a lot of work for them. So next time we go in the car, I will bring the camera and I'll show you a little bit of what the island looks like. I must say the cleanup was really quick, so that was a good thing. And we didn't put our barbecue back up on the deck because I just didn't want it to blow off, so I might as well just leave it down here anyway. I haven't used it since the rat incident anyway, so. All right, so there's our yard after what they called was a tropical storm. That was Tropical Storm Fay, but they think it was pretty much a hurricane once it did hit us, so. There you go. Okay.
So that's our yard at that point, at this point. So, and then the good news is today is Monday and we're getting hit with Tropical Storm Gonzo. What the hell's it? What's the new storm coming? Gonzales. No, it's got an O in it. Oh, Gonzales. Is that what it is? Okay, thank you. Gonzales is coming. Let's check out Bermuda Weather Service. That's apparently going to be a direct hit Thursday or Friday night. Good times. So, and we're thinking that it's going to hit Thursday night. So we'll see what happens there. Tropical Storm Gonzalo. There it is. Local advisory map only? No. So I'm just on the Bermuda Weather Service. Yeah, it's coming right to the south of us. It's saying Thursday it's coming. There's an advisory. It's sustained winds right now at 56 knots, but they say if it reaches us, the sustained winds will be 110 knots. Mm-hmm. So, but Fay, on the weekend, they were saying, okay, you know, it's going to be tropical gusts to 25 to 35 knots, and it was not. It was a sustained, I think, about 70 knots, and it was crazy. It was like 65, 70 knots. So they think it kind of was became a hurricane as it was going over us. As far as I've heard, no one was hurt. 27,000, there's about 69,000 of us on the island, and 28,000 lost power. And as of now, I think there's still about 8,000 people without power. So we ended up in the hotel last night. Scott had to stay. He was working until 12:30 in the morning or something. He had gone in yesterday. I was scared to death about him going in. He took a scooter and he was able to get around fallen trees and stuff. And then he had to go across the golf course on his scooter to get there because there were so many trees down, and power lines. So he ended up staying in a room that had, water. The water had come in and the carpets were soaked, so they had to wash the carpets. So the carpets were wet. But he stayed there last night and he said, well, you guys might as well come over. So the kids and I stayed there with him. And then we just basically stayed there, used the washroom, got a shower, and came home this morning. Our power was back on this morning, thank God. But the problem was, I don't know how long the power was out. I know it was out for at least 12 hours that we know of, before we ended up going to the hotel. Because it went out at 6, and then last night at about 6... No, it was 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock, the kids and I were sitting here with candles, and Scott said, just come over to the hotel, grab me a change of clothes. We went over there. So at least 14 hours we know of that the power was still out. So the food in the fridge was, you don't know, because we came home today and the power was on. But I know at least it was out for about 12 to 14 hours. So I had to throw out the contents of the fridge. I mean, I kept ketchup, I kept Eggos. Scott's like, what the heck can happen to an Eggo? We kept Eggos, but I had to throw chicken and milk and eggs and all that kind of stuff, cheese. And yeah, so that was fun, because you know how expensive food is here on the island. Yeah. Oh, and Phyllis, I saw your friend's ship. Phyllis, I told her that we were alive and everything was fine. And she said a friend of hers was coming on the Boston to Bermuda ship, and I saw the ships out there today. There was two ships. So they got in. The airport lost part of its roof, and the whole arrivals hall and customs area was apparently flooded yesterday. Some people lost parts of their roof. We saw a school that lost part of its roof. One of the schools is, I think they have like 8 classrooms that are messed up. What else? But like I said, no one was hurt. So there was no school today. We don't know about tomorrow. The website isn't working for the school, so we assume there's no power for them. I don't know. So we're just waiting to hear. If you go on Burr News, B-E-R News, it shows some pictures and stuff from the storm. And I got all my little birdies out, and Peach came running up to the door when we came home today. So she's okay. Her little back tail feathers are a little screwed up, but she's good. And Dad was here. He was here last week. He just flew out on Friday, so he got out of here at a good time. He was here for a week, and we did some stuff. We worked on the car and fixed some things in the car. So I have a couple video clips that I'll insert. Hey guys, how you doing? I am stuck in traffic. Today is Friday, October 3rd, and Dad is on his way. He's on the plane, and I'm trying to get to the airport, but I don't know what's going on up here, but we are stuck. There's traffic going past me. I think they're paving. What else? So yeah, so it's Friday. Yay! I did as much cleaning as I could. Although this morning I got up and there was ants all over the kitchen. So I kind of had a bit of a meltdown about that. And then I sprinkled baby powder everywhere. So we look like cokeheads or something. Because there's baby powder like everywhere. Because the ants hate baby powder. Apparently. I don't know. It kind of stops them in their tracks, but I had to take the dishes all out of the cupboard and throw them in the dishwasher to wash them.
It's a
Dad's been here 20 minutes. He's ranting already. What were you ranting about there, Dad? Someone making an illegal left? Yeah. We're just coming up the front of the hotel. We will have many videos this week. We're just going up to get them checked in.
We have a grand slam, a golf tournament.
Oh, yeah, look out. Here's the golf course. Here's the hotel. I better turn the camera off before we get in an accident. Great, so we're just in Dad's room. He's on the corner. He's got a lounge chair. This is room 328. And you can see the spa chairs over there. That's the indoor pool over that way. Here's the golf course. And there's the pool. You know, if I was on a roller coaster, I could handle this height, but just standing here, it freaks me out a little bit. So, and there's the front of the hotel. And where's my car? Oh, you can't see my car, but my car's over that way. So, it's a nice spot. We're gonna do some golfing one of these days. We have to go get the kids in a little bit. This is his room. A chair, a little desk area. There's a connector to this one. And here is the washroom. Bathroom area. Cool. TV. Reading lamps. It's a nice spot. You can see the ocean. Well, it's a nice day. There's a bit of a breeze. It's not too hot. We're home. We're going through bags that Annette sent. She always sends us little... I'm not putting you on video. She always sends us treat bags when Dad comes down. So she gave the girls some stuff. They're just going through it now. And she got me a little mesh lingerie bag and some letters and little stickers. These are from Michaels, called Phase 2. And these little trim borders. And these ones in orange. And a little thing of tags. And then this, check it, it's an EK tool. She got it for $3 at the dollar store. Little pumpkin. Kerrigan got some stuff. Do you want to show what you got, Kerrigan?
Don't show me. Don't
I'm not showing you. I'm showing your bag. Little Bath and Body Works little bag. Oh, there's tissue. Oh my God, it's adorable. Little tiny bag. Cute. Oh, that's cute. Little bag. Oh.
I'm not showing
it. Kleenex. A swanky hanky. Oh, nice. Oh, pumpkin spice
latte.
Latte and sweet cinnamon pumpkin Bath and Body Works. Oh. Mini clips. Those are adorable. That's really cute. They're highlighters. They look like nail polish. Oh, and some Halloween washi tape. Oh my God. A lot of Halloween. Adorable.
$125.
Trick or treat. From the dollar store. Oh my God. Cute. Pumpkins. Cute. Adorable. And then, what did you get, Brynn? Same kind of stuff. And then these are the duvets that I ordered from IKEA. So Dad, I sent them to Dad's house and he brought them down. So this is like a summery one. This one is called That, because I can't pronounce it. And then I got this plaid one called That, because what I'm going to do is use the plaid in, it's like a green and gray, and I'm going to use that one in the like fall and winter, and use all four pillows from both sets, and then use this one in the spring and summer. And then of course my Millies and my Flakies, Dad and I already got into the Flakies. Those are my favorite cakes. passion thickies. And then Annette got me this at IKEA, a scrubby brush. I love their scrubby brushes. And then Dad brought two of these down for the girls because it's peanut-free candy. It's by Nestle, and it's peanut-free in Canada. So it's Aero's, Smarties, Kit Kats, and Coffee Crisps. And then he actually bought Scott and I a set of sheets. He got them at Costco. And they have like four pillowcases with them. So very excited about that, to have new sheets to go with my new, our new duvets. So we're just down at Ocean Club. We're gonna come down here for dinner. Sun's starting to set. Just tidying up the beach chairs. So Ocean Club's kind of like the fish restaurant. This is where they filmed the auditions for the X Factor thing that I was telling you about in the last video. Contestants, and then when Louis came out of the little host thing on the beach, it was there. It was the dive shop. Just kind of funny. But out here is where they did the auditions on the deck.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, they tried to get down twice and couldn't get.
So we got a gorgeous Sunday here today. It's almost too hot to go to the beach, so we're just waiting for Dad. He's going to come on his scooter, and the five of us are going to go out to Dockyard, take a little scooter ride. So Kerrigan's going to come with me, Bryn will go with Scott, and then Dad's on his own on his bike. And we're going to take a little scooter ride. I think the weather's going to be good. Yeah, blue sky out that way. So, it's beautiful. Nice day. So we're just out here at Dockyard, and they've had a tent set up. It was for Oktoberfest at the Frog and Onion over that way. We're just wandering. No cruise ships in today, but we're gonna just kind of wander around. So we just went to lunch here at the little bistro. It's a good little restaurant. So we're just gonna take a walk around. It's pretty quiet out here today. We're gonna see if they're blowing glass over at the glassworks place. I'm like under the car. We've now put my spare tire back under the car. We eventually go to the spa, but
they hang open. In the meantime, there's things to be done.
There's things to do. In the backyard, we have the we have the oil draining out of the lawnmower, and here we've been putting the the spare tire that's been in my trunk for a year and a half. That's now going under.
That's tight, Tanya.
Is it?
Yeah.
So what you're saying is, if I ever get a flat, I'll never get that out of there.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, sure.
Look, all you have to do, I just leave this little adjustable wrench in the car.
All right.
And look, just put this on it.
Yep.
Right. That's it.
Use that as a thing.
Yeah.
Cool. Now.
This would work. You know. Like that, it'll work too.
Yeah, but don't get that so tight, I won't be able to get that on.
No.
Not that I'll be changing my tire, but. And then this is something we can maybe play with later. Look.
What's that for?
That's come off of my windshield wiper.
Oh, okay.
Look so up.
All right.
That's the mechanics of my.
This thing here came in down here.
Oh, yeah, that always does. See, so here, let's take the trunk down and we'll lift the window up. Oh wait, don't lock the keys in.
Tools.
Tools. Well, they can stay. I might need those.
Oh yeah.
There we go. So see, this needs some strong epoxy on there.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah.
Because it needs to be held to the thing. And then this is just the cover that covers that all up.
And what holds the cover on?
A screw.
Oh, you have the screw?
No, that would have fallen out a while back.
Oh, okay.
I've bought many different screws from Gorham's, but it never held.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is to the glass.
Yeah. Here with Bob Vila with this episode of This Old Cottage. We got the epoxy setting up there over on the car. Got the lawnmower all tuned up. Hang on, I'm zooming into my eyeball. It's so great when Dad comes to visit.
So relaxing. Fixing everything under the
Dad, floor. You want to do the spa today? You want to go to the pool? A little round of golf? No, let's fix things.
Yeah, let's fix things. Yeah, we have to grease the car yet.
Seriously?
Yeah, we'll rotate the tires while we're at it.
Well, you did say something about transmission fuel.
Oh yeah, we're going to check the transmission.
Yeah, we're going to check the transmission later.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll just check the fluid level. Not a problem.
Yeah. It's good times. What is the temperature?
What else do you need fixed?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Really?
Everything else is fine.
Oh, wow.
I got a crack in my bird feeder, my bird bath.
Oh, we could have got some cement to fix that.
Yeah, we could have, but we didn't.
We didn't know, would it?
Hose fits down a coat of paint.
Get a roller.
Let's just enjoy the breeze.
Yeah, ocean breeze.
And the ocean.
Yes.
Okay, maybe for a little while.
All right, let's do that.
Would that be okay?
That'll be fine.
We're on break. Well, it's a beautiful day today, but I got the grass done. I did that this morning. I finished the grass. Dad helped me with the lawnmower yesterday. We changed the oil, and so I went around and mowed this front part this morning until the sweat was running down my eyelashes. Got some doves sitting on the thing. Poor Dad is sick today. He's got a cold. He thinks he might have caught it on the plane. People were all coughing and hacking on the plane, so poor guy. We went to town today and he helped me finish my window on the car and got that all fixed. And what else? So we did that, and then we came back here and he took a scooter back to the hotel, so he's just not feeling good. So we were gonna go to dinner tonight, but he is laying down. And what else? That's about it. I'm just wandering around outside because it's actually cooler out here than it is in the house right now. So anyway, so that's the story with Dad for today. He's still here till Friday, so hopefully he'll be feeling a little bit better tomorrow. Got my sneakers in the plant pot because they were full of grass earlier and I was trying to dry them off. So that's it. Alright, today is Friday.
October 10th.
October 10th. Dad's heading back. So what did you think of the island?
Lovely.
Yes, lovely.
Yes.
Dad was out of commission for a couple days.
Yes.
He had a sniffle.
I flew 6 hours to get a cold.
He got a cold.
I had a man cold.
He had a man cold.
Unlike a woman cold, I had a man cold that would just knock a woman out. Well, she'd still have to do chores and things like that, but...
We would still have to cook dinner, clean the house...
Now, a man doesn't have to do that.
No, because a man just gets wimpy.
With a man cold, you just couldn't
whine.
Do that.
No, you couldn't do that with a man cold.
Not with a man cold,
because you're sooky, and you're whiny.
Well, you do have fever and things
achy
like that.
Achy and stuff.
Yeah.
But my car is running great. Dad taught me how to shift my car. You can manually shift it. I didn't know these things.
She didn't know that. We put their spare tire in.
Got the tire under the car, fixed the back window.
Yeah, the wiper was falling off. We had to get glue. It was so technical. We had to get glue and glue it on.
And a screw. We got a screw.
Special screw with a special thread.
It was a machine screw.
Yes. Yes.
Finer threads on a machine screw.
Tanya could not identify a machine screw in a hardware store. Now, come on.
It was an entire aisle.
It was a quarter inch, 80 by 100, 3/4 inch machine screw. Now, why she couldn't pick that out, I have no idea. But she knows now.
I know now.
If she ever needs another one.
If I ever need another.
Just run over and pick it up.
It's right there.
33 cents.
Well, when she rang it in, it was $34.99. We were playing Name That Price at Gorham's there at the hardware store.
Oh.
Bad. Like barbecues and stuff. Twice as much. And the iPhone 6, Dad got... Where's your phone cover? Your phone thing.
Oh, it's in my bag.
Dad got an OtterBox for his phone. And,
$49.
$49. And the lady next to us was buying an iPhone 6 here in Bermuda. An iPhone 6. So here comes Scott to say goodbye.
Yeah.
An iPhone 6 here in Bermuda will cost you $1,549.
And you need a case.
And we need a case. Scott's having a fit because we told him we were leaving at 10 and it's 9:58. Absolutely. He was in a meeting.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. We'll see you at Christmas.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
Richards.
Yes.
I'm a very important busy man.
I know you're a very important busy man.
Everything okay at checkout?
Yeah. Anyway, all great.
Have a safe flight.
Yeah, thanks,
Scott. We'll see you in a little bit.
We'll see you at Christmas.
Alrighty.
Alright.
See ya.
Take care.
Alright, we're off to the airport. I'm going to be shifting, so I can't control the camera.
Right, here we go.
We're good?
Just like an international rally. I got my...
Oh, like a race car.
I'm belted in.
You're belted in. We're good to go?
Yeah.
Wrong side of the road?
Yeah, wait till we get the okay here.
All right. Over and out. I'm signaling already. But he's home now, and it's actually Thanksgiving in Canada, so happy Thanksgiving to my fellow Canadians. And speaking of Canada, I got a postcard the other day. This is from Heidi. Heidi, I don't... Whoops. I dropped you. Heidi, I don't have a... Oh. Is this you? Is this your address here? Because I don't know if this is the post office. It says Kamloops, McKinley. Is that your ad? I don't know. Anyway, I don't have your address, so send me your address so I can get a postcard out to you. But she sent this, and she lives in Kamloops, and she said she went on a trip to the Rockies with her French exchange student, and decided to get this postcard. She said, I hope you still recognize the Canadian animals. So I thought that was really cute. So thank you. She said, love your videos and you're very entertaining. Thank you so much. And she has two guinea pigs as well. She has two boy guinea pigs. So thank you, Heidi. Like your little Canadian flag at the bottom there. But speaking of returning postcards, there's a few of you that I don't have return addresses for. Maureen, I think I have an address from you somewhere. I'm not sure, but if you can send me your address again, that would be great. Yuki in Australia, I'd love to send you one. I don't have an address. Sue, Phyllis's friend, if you want a postcard back for me, I need your address. And who else did I not have? There was someone from a while back that I didn't have your address. I think I might have wrote it in my address book. But yes, Heidi, if you would like me to send you a postcard, please send, I think it was Patty. Where is Patty? Because I did not have an address for you to return a postcard. And some of them I've put down that I received and sent your postcard, and some of them I didn't put that I had sent it. So now I'm wondering if I ever did send it to you. So if you didn't receive a postcard from me and you sent me one, please let me know. Here it is, Patty, Waldfogel. I don't know how to say your last name. I didn't, I got your card back in July, but I didn't have a return address to send you one back. So, yeah, if you have, if you've sent me a postcard, and, or even if you haven't sent me a postcard and you want me to send you one, just email me. Just go on one of my websites. It'll be, they're written down below. Either one, I've got, either website, I have my email address there, so you can send me a return address. All right, okay. So I'm going to go. What am I doing? I'm catching up on laundry. What else? Oh, and I have to take the video off of here to get it on here to have it put in the video, which you just saw. Okay. It's like a time machine. I'm going back in time. All right, so... Hope you guys are doing good. We are okay. It's a really weird time of day for me to make a video. It's in the afternoon. It's like 4:30, so it's sun is coming through the window at a weird angle. But anyway, okay, so we're good. We got another hurricane on the way, so hopefully we'll be okay for that one as well. And I'll talk to you soon. Okay, take care. See ya. Kerrigan's showing me something really cool with the, what is it, the update?
For the iOS 8.2.
It's really cool. So apparently she can just call to Siri. And
I did
happened.
It. I did it.
Okay,
I already
do
did it.
It.
Hey,
see.
Siri.
No. I think she put you on hold. That's so cool.
No, stop it. Hey, Siri. Hey, Siri.
I don't think she's home.
Yeah, she is. Hey, Siri. This is much easier than pressing and holding.
Yeah. So what if you just, go slide to unlock? Is that easier?
No, wait.
Maybe she's locked in
hey,
there.
Hey, Siri.
Should you rub it like a lamp?
Hey, Siri.
Okay. All right.
So hey, Siri.
So I'll be back with more videos soon. Okay, bye.
Hey, Siri.